here on the left, you'll notice that we have a couple of what we call departments in the Restaurant Pro Express software. Now, all those are is you could think of them as sections of menu items. So if you had groups of menu items, you might have your drinks in one department, drinks in one section. You might have sandwiches in a section. You might have coffees. You might have smoothies in different sections. And these departments, if you will, these buttons here, allow you, as we create those during the menu programming process, allow us to segregate the items by different departments and such. So you can see that we have a few that are already pre-programmed into the system that we can use for testing, just basic items to give you a feel for how things work. So once you get done looking at these pieces, we just want to point out the other pieces of the screen as well, the other sections. Right over here in the white area is the invoice screen. And if we want to show items that are being rung up during the middle of an invoice, this is where we would do it. So let's actually demonstrate that real quick. What I'm going to do is I have to begin a shift before I can start adding items to the invoice. So I'm going to go down here to what we call our quick buttons, and I'm going to click Start and Shift. And this is going to prompt us to start to enter a starting drawer amount. Now this would be the amount that the cash drawer started with in cash. I'm going to just click zero and add it and just begin the session for now. And it's going to give me a message that the shift is now open. Now, if I want to go ahead and just add a few items to the invoice, you can just see how they populate here and understand that this is what the customer is going to receive on their invoice when the receipt is printed out. Another few pieces of the interface here that we want to point out, you'll notice around the interface, you'll have these up and down arrows. So we have it up and down here. These allow us, if we have a long invoice with a lot of items on it, see that once we get more than one screen can contain in terms of the items listed out on the invoice, then we might have need of scrolling up and down to look at the items on the invoice. And so we can use the up and the down arrows here to navigate this screen. These are here mainly because in a touchscreen environment, there's no easy way to just grab this scroll bar over here on the side and go up and down. So most of the times your cashiers need a little bit bigger button to touch to move things around. Now we also have these buttons over here, and you'll see that we just use them for several different controls. Now what you'll notice over here is that we have the same buttons, this blue set of buttons here, and then another set toward the middle lower center of the screen. And those correspond to the different menu departments and the menu items that we have as well. So the same kind of a scenario here. If we have more than about 7 or 8 departments here, we're going to overflow what we can actually see on this one screen. So these up and down arrows give us a way to scroll up and down through these departments so that we can quickly locate the other departments and access them. The buttons here in the middle of the screen, the left and the right arrow, let's say that we had more than about 25 or 26 items on a particular department, then those would overflow the main screen here as well. And in that case, we might need to scroll to the right or to the left to scroll through all the various items in those departments. Now, if we do really good programming, a lot of the times we can limit this so that it doesn't become an issue and we don't have to use these. But if you do need them, they're here definitely for us to use.